Hello friends, welcome back to our tutorial, Designing an Impressive Architectural Building in AutoCAD 2018 in PA. If you have been following along, go and open the file 00_015_DIAB where you save it. You can also download this file on the website, but if you don't have access to the file, just sit down and watch. Zoom in into this area. In this exercise, we're going to continue our modeling by drawing the beams and the lintel. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the box command. At the specifying first corner prompt, click Add this corner. At the specifying opposite corner prompt, click Add this corner. Now, at the specifying height or 2 point prompt, type -3 feet on your keyboard and press enter. Press enter to repeat the box command again. Click at this endpoint. At the specifying other corner or cube length prompt, click at this corner and press enter. Press enter to start the command again. Click at this corner and move your mouse cursor to this corner and press enter. Press enter to repeat the command. Start from this endpoint, this vertex. At the prompt, specify other corner or cube length. Click this vertex and press enter. The box command, always remember the last height that you used. Press enter to repeat the box command. At the prompt, specify first corner or center. Click on this vertex. At the prompt, specifying other corner or cube length, select this vertex and press enter. Continue in this manner until all the doors and window have a beams and lintel. Click on this corner and move your mouse cursor to the opposite corner. It's difficult for you to get the opposite corner because there is no reference wall here. So all you need to do, move your mouse cursor slowly into this area. Hover the mouse cursor into this area and move and hover it over here. Now move the mouse cursor slowly until the two temporal lines are snapped to a point. When the two temporal lines are intersect, click. Now press enter. Do the same thing over here. Select this corner. Hover the mouse cursor here and hover it here. Now move slowly into this area. When the two lines are intersect, click and press enter. Let's continue in the same manner until we complete all our lintels and beam. Now we need to convert all these 3D objects into one object. Now go to the Solid Edit tab and Boolean panel, select the Union command. The Union command asks you to select object. Go to the V cube and click the back face. Use a crossing window selection. Move the mouse cursor down, but be careful not to move down. You select the 2D entity. Move it approximately below the window sill and click. Press enter. Now hold down your shift key with your window mouse button and see what you have done. You see the 3D solid is now one object. Press escape. Do the same thing for this other object by going to the solid tab, Boolean panel, and select the union command. Click the back face and use a crossing window selection to select this object. Press enter. AutoCAD convert this object into this solid, this separated solid into one solid. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save as button. Rename this drawing to 00_016_DIAB and click the save button. Let's create a lintel for the the external linsets. Go to the Home tab, Modeling panel, and select the 3D solid. Type, change the width, type W, press enter, and change the width to 6 inches. Press enter. Type pitch, press enter, and change the height to 1 foot. Press enter. Type J, press enter, and change the justification to left. Now start from this point. Press escape. Press enter to repeat the polysolid command. Now we just only need to change the justification. All the other settings are correct. So click the justification or type J on your keyboard and select the right justification. So start from this point to this corner and this corner. Press enter. Press enter to repeat the command again. Start from this point to this corner, hold down your shift key and your middle mouse button to orbit this corner and this corner. Press enter. Move your mouse, do the same thing over here. Start from this corner, this corner, this corner, and hold down your shift key with your middle mouse button and this corner. Press enter. Repeat the same command. Start from this corner, this corner, and this corner. Press enter. Press enter again. Start from this corner, this corner, this corner. Press enter. Now select all of this solid that you just created. And select the move command. Move from this point. Turn on the auto mode. And type 9 feet on your keyboard. Press enter. Now select this bin and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. Add the prompt specifying base point or displacement mode prompt. Click at this corner, then add the specifying second point or array. Use the move the mouse cursor and hover the mouse into this area. Now move gently until you see this temporal intersection. Click. Press escape to get out of the corner. Now select this line, this beam, and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. Click into this area and move down. Turn on your audio mode. Type 1 foot and press enter. Now this beam is below 1 foot, the first beam. Select this beam and delete it. Now we need to get rid of this excess line. So let's use a different command. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the press pull command. Select the face of this beam and move it back. It snaps to this edge of this beam. Press escape. Now select this beam and erase it. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and select the make current button. Select this object and click. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and start the line command. Start at this and move. Draw this line straight and click. The distance isn't important at this moment. Press escape. Start the line command again. Start the line at this point and move it outside. When you see the perpendicular objects, now click. Press escape. Now go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the isolate button. Select this object and press enter. AutoCAD isolates this object. Now select this object, right click, isolate, hide object. Go to the home tab, layer panel, and start the line command again. Start a line from this point to this point. Press escape. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 6 inches and press enter. Select this line and offset it inside. This line and offset it inside. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the fillet command. Type M for the multiple option. Type R for the radius and press enter, and enter a radius of 0. Press enter to accept the to start the fillet command. Press escape to get out of the command. Now we want to draw three small beams in between this area. So first of all, let's draw a reference line. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and click the line command. Use the midpoint object snap and snap from this point. Now move to the opposite direction and use the perpendicular object snap. Snap. Press enter. Before we proceed in this at this moment, let's go back and change your workspace to drafting and annotation by going to the workspace, either from the quick access toolbar or to the status bar, and change it back to drafting and annotation workspace. Go to the home tab, utility panel, and select point style. Change the point style to this plus sign, the third point, and click OK. Now go to the layer panel and click the down arrow. Select the turn on the cabbage layer and make it the current layer. That way the point that you draw is going to be on the cabbage layer. Go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the divide command. At the prompt, select object to divide, select this line. At the enter number to divide, enter 4 and press enter. AutoCAD divide the line into 4 portions and place a point to the division. Now go and start the line command. Hold down your shift key and right click and select the node object snap. Snap from this point to this point. Press escape. Now go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the offset command. For the offset distance, type 2 inches and press enter. Offset this line 2 inches to the right and 2 inches to the left. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and click the down arrow next to trim and select the extend command. Select this line and press enter. Extend these two lines, this line. Press escape to get out of the command. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the rectangle command. Start the rectangle from this point to this point. Select, use a crossing window, and select just this area. Now hold down your shift key and use a crossing window again. Click, not a selecting window, crossing window, to deselect the rectangle and erase the other object. Now select this rectangle and use the copy command. Go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the copy command. At the specifying base point, use the node object snap. Hold down your shift key and right click. Select the node object and snap from this point. To snap to the destination point again, use the midpoint object snap. Press escape to get out of the command. Now select this rectangle and go to the home tab, modify panel, and select the mirror command. At the prompt specifying first mirror point, click at the midpoint, this midpoint, then move the mouse cursor either in this direction or this direction and click. Press enter to get out of the command. Now select these three rectangles that you have just drawn and move them to the 3D wall. 3D wall layers. You get a problem like this because when you use the isolate command, AutoCAD turn off all the other layer except the layer that you select to isolate. So now that you move this object on the off layer, AutoCAD give you a warning. One or more object has been moved to a frozen or turn off layer. Number of objects removed from selected set is 3. Just go ahead and close this dialog box. Now go to the home tab, draw panel, and select the polyline command. Start the polyline from this point. Continue to click until you get a close figure. When you get to this point, you can type C on your keyboard to close the figure. Zoom in into this area. Use a crossing window to select the polyline. Now hold down your shift key and deselect this line. Move this line into the 3D world layer. Now select this object and erase them. This object and erase them. Right click in the drawing area, isolate, end object isolation. Then go to the home tab, layer panel, and click the on isolate button. Auto guard bring all of your objects. Now go and change the workspace by clicking the 3D modeling in the quick access toolbar, or move to the status bar and change the workspace to 3D modeling. Go to the home tab, modeling panel, and select the extrude command. Select this object, press enter. Move your mouse cursor at the top and type 1 foot, press enter on your keyboard. As you can see, the objects are being drawn on the wrong layer. So go to the home tab, layer panel, and select make current button to make the 3D world the current layer. Select the object that you just extrude and use the move tool by going to the home tab, modify panel, and select the move command. At the specifying base point prompt, click at this vertex. At the specifying second point, or use the first point as a displacement, move onto this vertex and click. Now go to the quick access toolbar and click the match property. At the select source object prompt, select this object, select this, press enter to end the command. Go to the quick access toolbar and click the save button. In this tutorial, we'll continue to model our 3D walls. We use the polysolid command to draw the beams and move them afterwards. In the next tutorial, we're going to design the foundation. If you find this tutorial useful, please click the like and share it to your friend. If you have any comment or any question, or you want a specific tutorial, please leave a comment below. If you want to continue on this series or any other tutorial in my channel, please click the subscribe button. Thanks very much for watching. I hope to see you in the next class. Goodbye.